Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to your graduation ceremony. Congratulations on your achievement. Today's all about you, so relax and enjoy. I'm just going to run through a couple of things now about the proceedings of the ceremony so you know where to be and what to do. So you'll receive your testament or parchment from staff who will be located in the Eastern Ambulatory, just where you came in, and you'll make your way to the stage. You will then carry your testament with you as you cross the stage and stand next to the Chancellor or Presider. If you're wearing a mask, you may wish to remove this before you cross the stage as your photo will be taken. We recommend either removing your mask and leaving it at your seat or removing it just before you step on stage and place it in your pocket out of sight. We've now got a couple of videos to play for you to demonstrate what will happen during the ceremony. Here is the first part.
Welcome to your graduation ceremony and congratulations on your achievements. Today is about you, so relax, take it all in, and most of all, enjoy it. Before we begin, please remember to either turn off your mobile phone or switch it to silent. Keep any belongings like bags or umbrellas under your seat and leave them there when it's time to cross the stage. Speaking of seats, make sure you're sitting in yours. Seats will be labelled with a program containing your seat number and name. The order you're sitting in is the order which you'll be presented on stage, so stay in your allocated seat and leave any empty seats unfilled as people may arrive late. When it's time to make your way to the stage, look to staff in black polo tops. They'll prompt you to stand row by row and let you know where to walk. Staff may also be wearing white polo shirts or a graduation gown, so make sure you follow their direction at all times. Before you cross the stage, there'll be three checkpoints: at the middle doors, just before the stage, and on stage. At each point, say your name clearly but quietly to staff, who'll check you're in the correct order. If you're sitting on stage, staff will let you know before the ceremony what you need to do when collecting your testament. When you're in position on stage, step up to the black line. When your full name's announced, walk along the carpet to the Chancellor or Presider.
Okay, we're just going to pause it there for a moment. So when you reach the staff member on stage, your name will be checked again, as was stated previously. You'll then be asked to stand on the black line. When your name is announced, you will be required to walk across the stage and stand next to the Chancellor or representative. And please hold your testament on your right side. Other side. Yep. On your right side. So that it's positioned between yourself and the Chancellor. Ensure that you are facing forwards as the photographer will take your photo. We will now play the remainder of the video to explain what we need to do after the photo has been taken.
Walk through the side door to leave the stage and walk down the corridor. Take care, as the wooden floor is well polished and can be slippery in high heels. At the middle doors, turn left to re-enter the hall and use the middle aisle to return to your seat. There, you'll remain seated until the end of the ceremony. If you have any questions, please ask our friendly staff. And once again, congratulations and have a wonderful day.
All right, just a couple more things now. So after you leave the stage, you will be presented with an alumni bag by a staff member from the alumni team. We recommend that you don't use the bag to store your testament as it can, it's not quite big enough and could cause the edges of your testament to get damaged, and you don't want to actually have to pay the replacement fee to get that replaced. So please be aware that the ceremony is live streamed. You will all be able to watch it later on the university websites or YouTube channels. Your mortarboard should sit flat with the tassel like this, the tassel on your left. Okay, yep, it's looking pretty good. So please make sure there's a Velcro strap at the back. You want to have that fairly firm before you cross the stage so that your hat doesn't sort of suddenly fall off as you're walking across the stage. So just make sure it's a firm fit. Also, if you're wearing stilettos, please be very careful when walking along the walls of the hall, as there are grates on the floor that you may get stuck in. So staff will help check your regalia in the corridor before you get to the stage, but please let staff know if you don't want to have your regalia adjusted. At the end of the ceremony, you'll be prompted to walk out two by two as part of the academic procession to exit Bonython Hall. If you need to use the facilities, please do so after this briefing. If you move from your seat once the ceremony starts, you may miss out on being presented. So just the toilets are at the back of the hall, just down the stairs. Once you're outside, enjoy the day with your family and friends, and once again, congratulations and have fun.
Graduates, congratulations.
You did it.
Well done and congratulations.
You now join a very, very special list of elite people from around the globe.
Alongside astronauts,
prime ministers,
and everything in between.
It's now your time.
You've joined a global community
of achievers, believers,
innovators, and creators.
A community of history makers.
We know that these are big shoes to fill,
but we also know that you've got this.
It's a great thing to reach the end point and to celebrate your graduation today.
Well done, and congratulations.
And not just to you, but to your mum, your dad,
your grandma, your grandpa,
aunts, uncles, your dog, cat,
and even your pet iguana.
They've all supported you to achieve your best.
Be proud of what you've done.
We certainly are.
So for you guys now,
take a breath.
Drink it in. Watch some Netflix.
Go on, you earn it.
And know that the world is ready for you.
And you're ready for the world.
In a year of making history and living it,
we can't wait to see what history you'll make
as graduates of the University of Adelaide.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the University of Adelaide graduation ceremony. This afternoon's ceremony is for graduates from the Faculty of Sciences, Engineering and Technology. The ceremony will commence very shortly. The university has a contract photographer to provide photography services during the ceremony. If you wish to take photos, I would ask that you do so discreetly from your seat, and please do not use the flash. To maintain the ceremony's sense of occasion, please switch your mobile phones off or to silent. In case of an emergency, please follow the direction of staff members. The emergency assembly point is on the Goodman Crescent lawns to the western side of Bonython Hall, and the evacuation plan can be found on page 9 of the program. For safety reasons, guests are not to enter the galleries upstairs, and please do not sit on the steps in the balcony area. Thank you, and enjoy the ceremony. The academic procession is about to enter the hall. We will be singing the national anthem. The words are on page 8 of the program. Please now stand, if you are comfortably able to do so, for the academic procession, and remain standing for the national anthem.
I, Catherine Branson, Chancellor of the University of Adelaide, declare open this congregation convened for the purpose of presenting degrees. Distinguished guests, friends, relatives, parents, especially graduates, welcome to the University of Adelaide's graduation ceremony. Gana Miana, Gana Yata, Nadlu Thumbindi, we recognise we're on Gana land. We acknowledge the Kaurna people, past and present, the original custodians of the Adelaide Plains, and thus of the land on which all of the University of Adelaide's campuses are built. We acknowledge the Kaurna people's ongoing spiritual connection to this beautiful land. Graduates, your graduation is an event in which you can take great pride, and I know your family and friends take pride in it. You may not have realised, but the University of Adelaide takes great pride in your success as well. I can't help but be conscious that when I stood in this fine hall, now very many years ago, to receive my degree, my life from then followed a path that at the time of the graduation I couldn't even have contemplated. Now, on your graduation day, you might like to think a little about the importance of keeping your mind open to the opportunities that might come your way in future years, opportunities to fulfill positions that may not even exist on this your graduation day. But whatever direction your life takes, I'm confident that the knowledge you've gained here, the skills you've developed, will stand you in very good stead, not only in your working professional life, but I'm confident in your all aspects of your future life. It now gives me great pleasure to introduce to you today's graduation orator, Mr. Mark Damon. Mark is the executive chairman of FIFE, a fully integrated engineering, environment, planning and survey firm, employing over 350 staff across major capital cities and regional centres in Australia, but headquartered here in Adelaide. In his impressive 35-year career at the company, Mark has held various roles, including 14 years as managing director. He is motivated by the relationships he's developed with his staff and clients, and enjoys seeing both the company and the people they serve flourish. Mark is the current president, the preceding vice president, and a councillor at the South Australian Chamber of Mines and Energy, and past president of the Australian Pipeline and Gas Association. He holds membership with the Australian Institute of Company Directors, the Petroleum Exploration Society of Australia, and Australian Pipeline and Gas Association. Mark was recognised as the Entrepreneur of the Year in 2014 Central Region Services category at the Entrepreneur Awards, an accolade which is considered to be one of the world's most prestigious business awards and is held in more than 145 cities in over 60 countries worldwide. Mark completed a graduate certificate in management in 2000 from the University of South Australia. He also has an associate diploma in information technology from Adelaide Institute and a survey technician certificate from the South Australian Institute of Technology. We're privileged to hear him speak today. Please join with me in welcoming Mr. Mark Damon.
Thank you, Chancellor, for your kind welcome. It is a pleasure and a privilege to be your guest speaker at today's graduation ceremony. Firstly, I must acknowledge some key people. The Honourable Catherine Branson, AC, KC, Chancellor of the University of Adelaide. Dr. Jessica Gallagher, Deputy Vice Chancellor, External Engagement of the University of Adelaide. Professor David Lewis, Head of School of Chemical Engineering, Faculty of the University of Adelaide, distinguished guests, and especially the graduates. It is with great enthusiasm that I congratulate every graduate here today for the graduation ceremony. Today is a formal recognition of your significant achievement that will provide the cornerstone for your future career. Today is a time to celebrate and reflect on the journey that you have traversed. Importantly, is an opportunity to thank the university and staff and your colleagues that have assisted your journey. Enjoy the moment and the day. No doubt many of you are already well underway with your career. You were fortunate to be graduating in a buoyant time in the economic cycle. Sure, there are plenty of stories out there of concerning economic stories, and there are some sectors that are softening. But my market observations and intelligence show ongoing growth across many sectors. The company I work for employs around 120 of our 400 staff. It's gone up from that 350 and continuing to grow. So 120 of those people have an engineering degree of some nature. 36 of those are chemical engineers, and I'll use two of these chemical engineers as an example. They came through the University of Adelaide and at a young age became general managers and shareholders and on the board of our company. In South Australia today, there is an abundance of opportunity for our graduates. And we need your talent to deliver those huge opportunities that have been announced for our state. And I think the state is really moving into a different space these days. As I mentioned, you're in a market where your skills are in demand. There is a big opportunity to build your experience, your reputation, and your career. For this, I will give you some of my thoughts, and I'll say, as basic as they will sound. Think about your personal values and how you want to present yourself to the business world. Building your personal brand is a very long journey throughout your career, getting known for what you stand for. Invest in your career every day. If there's a networking opportunity or a learning opportunity, a colleague looking for assistance, take that opportunity. Building relationships in your industry is a career-long journey. And I can just say, I never miss a networking opportunity. Throughout your career, you'll receive feedback. Often people will tell you what you want to hear rather than what you need to hear. When somebody tells you what you need to hear, they're trying to help you. So be a good listener. In your career journey, collect advice and opinions. These will form the basis of your thoughts. No matter what path you choose, an important point often missed is do what you say you'll do. If you commit to a client to deliver a project on a certain date, make sure you do it, or let the client know you may be delayed. Don't let it slide. And also, put your hand up if you need assistance and seek experience. This practice will build trust in your reliability. These previous points relate to being good to deal with in business. If you want people to provide you with opportunity, it really helps if they like you and respect you. I'm sure all of this will sound obvious to you, but my experience is that it is not as common as you would expect. My point is, the simple things can make you stand out. And summing this up with a well-known motto, aim to be the best team player rather than the best player in the team. I mentioned the economic cycle. There's no doubt that will change. There's nothing surer. Constant change driven by technology and community values will be ever present. And in my view, constant change is not something new. It's always been part of our life. While you're young, it's a great time to seek opportunities. You can prepare yourself to be flexible and valuable to a wide range of opportunities. A time will come when you know what you want to establish as your deep keel in your career. And that can deliver the ambition for your work and your life. Be patient, but persistent. As your career grows, make sure people know your thoughts and your ambitions. To satisfy that ambition, you'll need to take risks, and at times, you just got to back yourself. You'll receive some great opportunities. They may be from big public companies or smaller private ones. And if it's those smaller private ones, seek meaningful ownership in the company. There's not too much that can match that option for career success and satisfaction. Thank you for listening and congratulations on your achievement, and I wish you all the best for your future career. Well done. Thank you.
Thanks, Mark. Very nicely done.
On behalf of the graduates and their families attending today's ceremony, I would like to thank Mr. Mark Damon for his stimulating and inspiring addresses. We are honored that you have taken the time to join us on this special day to share with us your thoughts and experiences. Your words of encouragement and advice are greatly appreciated. They remind us that education places upon each of us an enduring responsibility to make the best possible use of our talents and to contribute to the betterment of society in whatever way we can. Please join me in once again thanking Mr. Mark Damon.
I will now receive the candidates for degrees. I call on the Deputy Vice Chancellor, External Engagement.
Chancellor, I, Dr. Jessica Gallagher, Deputy Vice Chancellor, External Engagement of the University of Adelaide, certify to you and the whole university that the graduates who will be presented to you have all fulfilled the conditions prescribed for admission to the award for which they are so presented.
I, Catherine Branson, Chancellor of the University of Adelaide, by virtue of the power committed to me by the university, confirm that each graduate is admitted to the rank and privileges of a holder of the award in the University of Adelaide for which they are so presented. I call on the head of the School of Chemical Engineering, Professor David Lewis, to present the graduates.
Chancellor, I, the head of School of Chemical Engineering, Professor David Lewis, present to you graduates from the Faculty of Sciences, Engineering and Technology. To the honours degree of Bachelor of Chemical Engineering, Danae Selena Bedison Estrella. C. Mukan Jan. Also receiving the Bachelor of Finance, Lachlan Aidan Kotup. Zhe Yu Guan. Zara Elizabeth Jackson. Patrick Max Klinger. Dongguan Li. Andre Lewinsky. Lachlan Bryce Maliford. Josephine Diane Mathias. T. Min Tu Nguyen. Noyen Tron Tin Pham. Ti Mi Ing Phan. Elise Hannah Potesny. Michael Ivan Bernalis Santos. Helena Lily Schwert. Shukrin Hana Sharul Azman. For now, Ralph Solano. William Tang. Alina Ni Ing Jung. Nok Min An Jun. Chining Wai. To the honours degree of Bachelor of Engineering, also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Finance, Owen John Adams. Also receiving the Bachelor of Finance, Callan Haman Bratton. Dylan James Bushell. Long Tan Luan Gao. Benjamin Thomas Davies. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Finance, Grace McKay Dawson. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Mathematical and Computer Sciences, Franco DeAngelis. Rowan Joel Erdy. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Finance, Callan Godfrey. Troy Gareth Goldsworthy. Chelsea Hua. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Science, Isla May Heath. Helen Lei Ho. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Finance, Coco Jingming Tian. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Mathematical and Computer Sciences, Amelia Lucy Johnson. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Science in Biotechnology, Simon William Yuhup. Barbara Karagiorgis. Alexander Zhu Knight. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Finance, Jung Duk Lam. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Mathematical and Computer Sciences, Wei Kan Lu. Yu Tao Lu. Sharon Rose Ruvarashi Mutandwa. Huang Zan Nguyen. Nam Tun Nguyen. Viet Hua Ti Nguyen. Zali J. Evans-York. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Science, Lucy Kate Penner. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Finance, Benita J. Prakashpillai. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Mathematical and Computer Sciences, Luke Alessa Sandrett Smith. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Mathematical and Computer Sciences, Naomi Smith. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Finance, Nathan Jordan Spence. Isaac James Cullum Tinay. Andy John. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Mathematical and Computer Sciences, Linkus Thomas Cunningham Besley. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Finance, Jack Michael Walsh. Charles Hardy Waterman. Caleb Antoine Watson Tron. Daryl Sunshe Wong. And Nahalina Yu. To the honours degree of Bachelor of Engineering and Bachelor of Arts, Ruby Isabel Milroy Thomas. To the degree of Master of Petroleum Engineering, Tobias Christian Minsen. Also receiving the degree of Master of Petroleum Engineering Science, Rowan Jeffrey Robert. To the degree of Master of Engineering Chemical, Zhe Meng Xiong Zhou. And Zhen Tang. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy for a thesis entitled Computationally Efficient Techniques for Well Control and Placement Optimization Under Geological Uncertainty, Dr. Yazan Arahi. For a thesis entitled Agglomeration Characteristics of Olivine Sand During Combustion and Gasification of Potassium or Silicon Rich Agricultural Residuals, Dr. Gulay Lee. For a thesis entitled Revealing the Conversion Mechanisms in Metal Sulfur Batteries via Computational Methodology and In-Situ Spectroscopy, Dr. Juan Lee. For for a thesis entitled Enhancing Green Hydrogen Production During One and Two-Stage Catalytic Pyrolysis of Biomass with Mechanochemically Prepared Char Supported Ion Catalyst, Dr. Richard William Thompson. For a thesis entitled Designing Advanced Electrode Materials for Rechargeable Magnesium and Sodium Batteries and Spectroscopic Investigation, Dr. Xing Zhu. For a thesis entitled Electrocatalytic Refinery Toward Green Production of Chemicals Through Nitrogen and Carbon Dioxide Electroreduction, Dr. Daju Yao. And for a thesis entitled Controls on the Sedimentology and Paleo-Environmental Evolution of the Permian and Trisaic of the Sydney Basin, New South Wales, Australia, Dr. Zhang Yan, Yu. To the Bachelor of, to the degree of Bachelor of Science, Vishva Amar Rush. Ingan. Christina Norzel Ari Aran Scott. Rochelle Sarah Aves. Ka Ken Chan. Kiatisuk Christu. Joshua Luke Coker. Harriet Jane Cooling. Mitchell Robert Cunningham. Also receiving the Diploma in Languages, Alethea Dharma. Romina Simone DiCorso. Heidi D. Kai Bailey Edwards. Julia Alexandra Erseg. Amber Frost. Toby Paul Garvin. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Nashley Aaron Griffiths. Also receiving the Diploma in Languages, Whitney Drew Hagenis. Eloise Zoe Hart. Natasha Lee Hyotis. Connor Jessup. John Henrik Johannesson. Alex Brett Keast. also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Winona Ali Kennedy. Bronwyn Rebecca Lee. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Ellie Scarlett Leopold. Rachel Kate Matthews. Isaac, thank you, pardon, Alice McIntyre. Isaac Ben Milhouse Taylor. Isaac Alexander Nicone. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Emilia Rose Mira Djindjinovic Newlands. Lachlan Paul Paparella. Lei Mung Guan Pham. Vinayesh Sanjivanad Premanad. Lauren Rose Rowe. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Alexandra Irene Rosewarne. Ted Hugo Schmall. William Paul Schubert. Xanthi Esther Sophia Shaw. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Bradley Taylor Steed. Also receiving the Bachelor of Mathematical and Computer Sciences, Radhi Stefanov Chorjabi. Charlotte Rose Tidswell. Also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Lauren Rose Treneri. Gemma Isabella Virtue. Samuel Lloyd Walsh. Yifei Zhou Wong. Talia Jean Walford Stewart. Courtney Grace Welsh. Holly Grace Wright. And Phoebe Ada Yeomans. To the degree of Bachelor of Science Advanced, Berta Ol Bracht. Annie Tanya Baker. Holly Carol Maria Bulldog. Liam Matthew Carson. also receiving the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Advanced, Jack Chershu. Drace Diane Conlon. Holly Madison Cook. Joshua Gabriel Cudmore. Chelsea Jade Forbista. Nicholas James Francis. Z. Gold. Josiah Ethan C. Jaden James Angus Jarman. Macy May Cottrell. Julia Leaf Lang. Emma Yushin Mao. Megan Rachel Monahan. Laura Rose Murray. Michael James Murray. Indiana Brooke Newman. Amelia Carla Orchard. Madeline Darcy Parks. Nathan Partazo Elliott. Lachlan Max Poynton. Haley Isabel Purnell. Luke Jacob Quinlan. Mitchell Lewis Richardson. Timothy Jisingh Tarava Raja. Georgia Louise Thorpe. Rachel Emily Van der Ploeg. And Kate Patricia White. To the Honours Degree of Bachelor of Science, Keshvinder Singh Amesk Sin. JC May Bampton. Imogen Merla Sharok Barnsley. Sarah May Battersby. Stephanie Jane Bakley. Gabio Brito Montero. J. James Henry Brown. Maxim John Buckley. Lachlan John Callahan. Samuel Colin Chalmers. Nicole Caitlin Crowhurst. Oh, sorry, beg your pardon. Ruth Nellie Coop. Nicole Caitlin Crowhurst. Connor Liam Dalton. Louis D'Antonio. Marnie Grace Denley. Leanne Nicole D'Souza. Isabella Donato. Maya Liza Doyle. James Edward Napier Gallagher. Carly Nanette Gifford. Matthew James Green. Kimberly Noelle Hanley. Cameron Cooper Harris. Dana Nicole Imbrogno. Alessia Impala. Christian Camley. Alexandra Kloss. Co Terry. Samuel Austin Kirschmer. Lee Kang Hung. Cassidy Lee Bushka. Ling Yuan Lee. James Alexander Lyons. Amy Gilak Liu. Dominic James Lyford. Edward Madbach. Thomas Oliver McGovern. Miran McKay. Jackson Andrew Mickley. Hannah Ray Morgan. Kaidi Irene Morgan. Reese Vincent Morgan. Jacob Gideon Penny. Douglas Roy Perot. Savinu R.G. Chandra Sagaran. Ben Thomas Robertson. Matthew John Rohde. Jared Mark Ross. Jake Richard Rowland. Matthew Rumley. Harry Peter Rigby Rust. Matthew James Schultz. Damon Thomas Schnell. Zoe Grace Stephen. Fedor Tali. Rhiannon Ashley Van Eck. Vartan Edward Varparian. Emmeline Page Virgo. Jemiah Chloe Watson. Olivia Louise Wells. Lucy Bell Wood. And Yushuan Zhou. For the degree of Master of Science, Divya Darshini Chinatambi. Chancellor, this concludes the graduates from the Faculty of Sciences, Engineering and Technology for this ceremony.
Chancellor, every year the university presents university medals to acknowledge the most outstanding graduates in each faculty who have completed a University of Adelaide bachelor's degree with honours or a bachelor's degree of at least 4 years duration. The university medals are awarded to them for their consistent, outstanding performance across the whole of their undergraduate studies. I, Dr. Jessica Gallagher, Deputy Vice Chancellor, External Engagement at the University of Adelaide, present to you the recipients of the 2022 University Medal from the Faculty of Sciences, Engineering and Technology. Leanne Nicole D'Souza. And Jackson Andrew McKinley, Mickley. Chancellor, University Doctoral Research Medals are awarded to graduates who have completed outstanding research at a doctoral level. This award is the premier award for doctoral candidates at the university. I, Dr. Jessica Gallagher, Deputy Vice-Chancellor, External Engagement, University of Adelaide, present to you a recipient of the 2022 University Doctoral Research Medal for research in the School of Chemical Engineering and Advanced Materials, Kamrul Hassan.
It's now my great pleasure to introduce to you today's valedictorian, Zigor, who will speak on behalf of all those graduating today. Please welcome him.
Thank you for choosing me to give the valedictory address. I'm honored to be standing here today and to represent my graduate cohort. I never expected my bachelor's to have made such an impact on me. Looking back, it's quite a foolish notion to have. I'm studying abroad, I'm getting a uni degree, I'm figuring out what I want to do with my life. Of course it'd be impactful. But as someone who had just uprooted his life and quite possibly lost all his friends for the second time, it was pretty hard to look forward to new and exciting experiences, especially with new people. And I was mainly focused on my studies. You see, growing up in the Malaysian education system, we were mainly graded on our exam results. And I quickly learned, so did everyone else, that rote memorization was the winning strategy. I don't know if that's how they still do it nowadays, but the point is, those 11 years I spent in that education system spelled trouble for me. I knew I wanted to do research, so much so that I was already enrolled in the direct entry honors program. But I also knew that my critical thinking skills and my creative problem-solving skills were severely underdeveloped. I even remember how confused I was after my first lecture on S and P orbital hybridization, or even how stressful my first practical session was. It was overwhelming, to say the least, and I didn't know how I could even begin tackling these challenges. But in the end, what motivated me for my bachelor's was the realization that I had to take a more active role in my learning. You see, like all international students, my time here is limited, and I had to pay much higher course fees. So I didn't really have the privilege to take a half-time load or to switch degrees. My parents worked really hard to give me an education, and I felt that this was the least that I could do. So I knew where my skills were, where I wanted them to be. I even had the motivation. But what I didn't know was how I could get from point A to point B. So this is where my bachelor's experience comes in. Unfortunately, I don't really remember much of my bachelor's experience, but what I really remember is the other people I've met, people like my lecturers. It was evident from day one that they were really passionate about teaching and that they were experts in their field. I found the courses that they designed very well organized, and they truly challenged me and pushed me to develop the aforementioned skills that I was lacking. And then there's my peers, people like my friends and my partner, who made the 5.5-hour pracs and weekly lab reports bearable, and made these past 3 years much, much more enjoyable. I guess my point is that the reason I mainly remember these people is because I couldn't have done my bachelor's without them. I've recently begun my HDR degree, something I couldn't have imagined doing just 3 years ago. And I couldn't have done it if not for the skills the teaching staff have patiently helped me to develop. And I didn't think I would have a social network that would make me feel that perhaps Adelaide could be a second home. But the friends I've been lucky enough to make have proved me wrong. Even now, I'm slowly improving on my HDR degree, thanks to the support of people around me, people like my supervisors, my fellow group members, and my peers. And so I'd like to invite my fellow graduates to stand, to keep in mind people like our family, our friends, our lecturers, who have all supported us during our time in university, and to give them a round of applause. Thank you. Please be seated. Looking back, I'm extremely grateful for the experiences I've had and the people I've met over these past 3 years, and how they've empowered me to achieve my goals and have shaped me to become a more well-rounded person. So before we close this chapter of our lives, I urge my fellow graduates to pause and to celebrate how far we've all come, to remember that sometimes we are more capable than we think we are, to be open to new experiences, and to always be grateful for the people who have supported us on our journey. Thank you, and I wish you all the very best for your future endeavors.
Thank you, Z. It now gives me great pleasure to congratulate as a group all those who received their awards today. Be proud of what you've achieved, and as Z has reminded you, remember those who supported you along the way. It will be your families, your friends, and I'm sure the fine staff of this university. I wish you every success as you enter this next exciting stage of your career. Indeed, on this propitious day, allow me to say, may the 4th be with you. As graduates of the University of Adelaide, you're also its alumni and you become its ambassadors. Over the years since this university was established, its alumni have made enormous contributions all around the world. Today, you join this community of more than 150,000 alumni, located in more than 135 countries in the world. We have 21 global alumni networks, and 8 of those are international networks. I hope you might think of joining one of those networks. Let me now thank again the Mace Bearer, Kamrul Hassan, and our valedictorian, Zigo, and all who assisted in the organization and running of today's event. I ask all of the graduates to remain seated, and I know there's been a lot of clapping, but let's stand just once more and congratulate all of today's graduates. Please, only if you comfortably can. Would the audience please remain standing? And the graduates now please stand for the academic reception. Once the academic reception has left the hall, we ask you to remain in your place, and university staff will help you exit the hall. I now declare this congregation adjourned.